Hey guys, Adam Lobo here from Adam Lobo TV, and in this video, I'll be giving you the unboxing and my first impressions of the OPPO Reno6Z 5G, so keep watching. Starting from the unboxing, similar to the Reno 5 series, it comes with a similar colored box with a pretty big number 6 on the top left and OPPO Reno6Z 5G down below. Then at the back of the box, there's the color variant that you choose and the RAM and the storage specs as well. Sliding the box cover reveals a black box, and opening that box brings you to another smaller box where in there you'll find a SIM ejector pin and the user manuals. Then you'll find the clear phone case. Underneath is the earphones, a USB-A to USB-C cable. Then finally, there's the 33-watt VOOC flash charge 4.0 adapter. Now looking at the build quality and the overall design and finish of the phone, even though I'm a huge fan of plain or a matte finish smartphone, this unique Aurora color has really grew on me. Now this is of course very similar to what OPPO has introduced in the OPPO Reno 5 series that I've of course reviewed previously. So this unique finish is called the OPPO Reno Glow, and I love the slight texture feeling of it as well, where it was something that no other smartphones had. Then the camera arrays are towards the left with a medium sized camera bump, so it will slightly wobble when you place it on a surface, especially towards the middle, towards the right side of the screen. And yes, the design is very similar to what you see in the OPPO A74 variants, but the difference is that the color finish is also on the camera bump as well. And speaking of the color finishes, other than the Aurora color that I have, it is also available in Stellar Black. Now looking at the ports and buttons, other than the USB-C port down below, you'll find the mono firing speaker and the headphones jack over there. On the right, there's the power button. Then on the left, there are the volume rockers and the SIM card and micro SD card slot with a dedicated slot for the micro SD card. So overall, the phone was indeed very sleek and quite lightweight as well during my first impressions, and I will give the phone an A for the overall design, build and how the phone felt in my hands. Next, looking at the display, if the rear finish of the phone was something that really stood out to me, the display has to be something which is really eye-catching as well. Now the phone has a 6.43-inch AMOLED display with a resolution of 1080 by 2400 pixels, and upon turning on the phone screen, I already felt that the phone screen was very pleasing to the eye with very great vibrant colors of the phone, as OPPO has very well known to have a great screen, especially for this Reno series. Then the camera hole punch is towards the top left with a 90.8% screen to body ratio, and since it comes with an AMOLED screen, it has the fingerprint unlock and there's also the face unlock as well, which unlocks pretty quickly. Then watching YouTube was really nice on the phone, and the phone is also Netflix and Amazon HD compatible as well, which I'm looking further to test out more. So yes, the screen is the second plus factor of the phone. Now in terms of the cameras, the main rear camera is a 64 megapixel f1.7 aperture 25mm wide lens, an 8 megapixel f2.2 16mm ultra wide angle lens, and a 2 megapixel macro lens. Then the front camera comes with a huge 32 megapixel lens. And based on my quick test shots, the front camera's pictures were great, both for the regular and the portrait selfie as well. But where the image quality really shines is through the rear lenses, where it looked really high in quality with amazing details and dynamic range, as how you would expect from the OPPO Reno series, especially with all the great AI scene enhancements in the camera app. And speaking of the AI enhancements, there are a lot of cool features like the bokeh flare portrait, ultra clear 108 megapixel image upscaling, AI palette and more, which of course I'm looking to test these features out further in my full video review. Now as for video, the rear camera can record up to 4K 30 frames per second, and the front camera is up to 1080p at 30 frames per second, where the videos look very stable with great stabilized video shots for 1080p for the rear and decent stabilization for the front video shots. Then looking at the specs of the phone, it comes with a MediaTek Dimensity 800U 5G chipset, where this chipset is built on the 7nm process, and it also comes with the Mali G57 MC3 GPU. Then the variant that I have is the 8GB of RAM plus 3GB expansion based on using your storage as expansion of that. Then speaking of the storage, this has 128GB of storage. Next, as for the battery, the phone comes with 4,310mAh of battery, which may or may not be small depending on how much that you use the phone daily, because I do find that MediaTek chipsets have better battery optimization, so let's see how that performs. And the phone has fast charging up to 33W, which is OPPO's VOOC Flash Charge 4.0, where the charger comes inside of the box, as you guys have seen in the unboxing. In terms of software, the phone comes pre-installed with ColorOS 11.1. And overall, I had no complaints with the software, and the overall interface with ColorOS version 11 onwards have been really pristine. So overall, it was really nice. And apparently, there's also other cool air gestures for some hands-free experience as well, and other cool software features. So I'm looking to dive into that too. So as of recording of this video, there's no official price for the phone that have been announced yet here in Malaysia. So stay tuned for that, where I will either update the pinned comment down below on the pricing, or I'll let you guys know during my full video review. So guys, with this, do let me know what you would like to specifically know about the OPPO Reno6Z 5G down at the comment section below, and either I'll reply to your comments directly or I might be answering them during my full video review of the phone. Aside from that, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. My name is Adam Lobo, and I'll catch you guys in my next video.